Hello viewers, my name is Spencer Strott, most of you may know me by the name of Lifestealer58, and welcome to the explanation on the rewards. Before I get into this, if you're watching this maybe 10 months ago whenever this video was released, I highly recommend checking the playlist down in the description and watching the newest video of that playlist, because I will be updating this pretty much weekly, hopefully, or maybe every 2 weeks, depending on how active people are and how much people achieve these rewards, and update you guys on who has the reward currently, or updates to the rules on the reward. Award or whether an award no longer exists or whether awards are added. So please make sure to go down in the description and watch the newest video to explain what is going on with the rewards. But if you're watching this currently, then welcome to the reward/award system. So just to briefly explain, this is something that's completely optional. It's just something fun to look at and be like, oh, hey, look at what you did. And I really want to make things clear that I don't want this to become a very competitive thing, and things may be changed just so they aren't as competitive, or, you know, or maybe slightly adjusted so the rules are a bit more fair. So make sure to check out the newest video to keep updated on that. So we're just going to go on each one of them and discuss what the reward means, the symbol of it all, and how to do it, all the warnings and stuff that you should be aware of, and all the good stuff like that. So just to be clear, this is something really unique. Obviously, you have trophies and achievements on Xbox and PS3 and PS4 and, you know, all that stuff. However, you don't actually have something exclusive to Worlds. So this is something brand new, and the reason why I'm mentioning this is instead of saying this idea sucks or these rules suck or this award sucks, please explain what you would do to improve it or what you would like to add, because I want this to be fun, fair, balanced, just something unique. And if I just get told I suck, that doesn't solve anything. So please feel free to list your opinions on what you would do in your opinion for any of these awards and stuff like that, because I want this to be fun and fair for everyone. And this is also very important. If any of you try and cheat or try and rig the system for each of these awards, you may lose points for the rewards, or you may be disqualified for participating in the awards. I'm not planning on banning you to do if you, like, completely destroy or cheat the rules or something like that, then you won't be banned, but you'll be disqualified from achieving that certain reward. You won't be banned from the world, I should say. So let's start with the first one, the social networker. As you can see, here's like the most brief description. Invite the most new players, must complete introvert. The reason why we have redstone dust as the icon is it's because it kind of represents a connection, because you need to have connections with other friends to get this award. To achieve this reward, you must invite the most friends or have the most friends join, as long as they get permission from me, and whenever the world is open, obviously. Anytime a friend that joins the world joins the party and then watches the introduction video and then plays on the world gets 1 point added to the social networker. So for example, let's say you invite 10 friends that join the world and then watch a video and all that stuff, then you have 10 points. However, if you are honest with me about someone who you do not trust, you will also get a point. I'll explain more in like this warning type of section. So this is a pretty big warning, so please listen up for this specific award, the social networker. So here are the warnings. Anytime someone new joins the world, I will ask someone in the party who's friends with this person. And if you are the one to say, oh, that's my friend, I will then ask you, do you trust them? You need to be honest with me about this. Never lie just so you can get points. If you're honest with me and say, actually, I have seen him grief one of my friend's worlds once, or yeah, he is actually very verbally abusive, then I will kick them out. That does not mean that you do not get any points if you're honest. It means that you will get 1 point for your honesty. So regardless of whether someone plays on the world because you trust them, or they play on the world because you don't trust them, or they get kicked out because you don't trust them, I should say, you'll still get points, because I would rather have you be honest and tell me, no, I actually don't trust this person, please kick him, than us, you know, take the risk to get points. So just literally, it's very simple. Just be honest. Get points. It's really as simple as that. I also never want you guys to let untrustworthy people join, because you can actually lose points on this award if your friend that joins breaks the rules. If you're wondering how many points you will lose, it depends on the scenario. So I can't think of any scenarios on the top of my head. I'm hoping I don't need to actually ever need to deduct points. But just in case you're wondering, that's what's going to happen if you don't actually be honest and tell me that, yeah, this person is a griefer and this world gets griefed and stuff like that. So just to recap this world, you get points for having your friend joining the world with my permission, have them join the party, and have them watch the CMA 2.0 introduction video, then play for a little bit. Be honest with who you would allow to play on this world, and you will receive points. If one of your friends does something bad to this world, then you will lose points for this award. For award number two, we have community contributor. as the simple term, is do tasks for the world. The more difficult, the more points you will receive. Obviously, that just says the more points. The reason why I picked a pickaxe is because I feel like if someone wields a pickaxe, they wield the opportunity to help, whether it is collecting resources or clearing an area for more space. So this award goes to the person who contributes to the world the most. So if you want to go for this award, ask me what needs to be done for the community contributor, and then I will give you tasks that could be done for the world. Each of the tasks will give you points, and you will get points based on a score of 1 to 12 and the difficulty of them. For example, if I say you can mine a stack of wood, you would receive 1 point because that is a very simple task. If I say I want you to mine this whole mountain down to bedrock, you would receive 12 points because this is such a long and hard task to do. I'll tell you the task and the amount of points for the things in the world that you can do for them. After the task is complete, the points will be added up to your overall points for this one. Some tasks, if you decide to stop halfway through, I may give you half of the points for that. Never ask for that though, and that's not a guarantee. That is only if I feel like the task is deserving of it. Nothing much negative here. If someone somehow makes something worse for the world, which you would need to do 100% intentionally, then you will not be able to achieve this reward. Again though, that will most likely never happen. You would need to intentionally try and get disqualified from this one. The next award, aka award number 3, we have BFF less than 3. BFF stands for best friend forever, by the way. Be respectful, player. Players will vote for the winner. The reason why this is a torch is because you need to light up the world like nobody else. So basically, again, you just earn this one by being a nice and respectful player and having people vote for you, obviously. So here's how the voting system works and how people will vote for the winner. Anytime someone leaves CMA 2.0, they will send me a private message of who they enjoyed playing with the most. If someone that you barely know voted for you, then you get 1 point added to your score. However, if someone that you know pretty well, such as a friend, votes for you, then you will get 0.5 points. I'm making this rule because this would turn into a popularity contest instead of just someone saying, hey, I actually enjoyed playing with that person. It just balances it out a bit more for the people who are new and don't have many friends that could vote for them. If the voting was equal points, where it would be friends voting for friends or a random voting for another random, then it would be a huge amount of difference between the points. So that is why there's a 0.5 system for friends voting for friends. And then we have the final one, which is the tryhards. So as you can see, win the most minigames. The tryhard icon is a gold helmet because it looks like a crown, and you would be the king of the minigames if you've won. And the award, obviously, as I said, goes to the person who has won the most minigames. So one win equals 1 point. However, we will always call it wins instead of points because it makes more sense for this award. So here are some warnings. These should be very obvious. If you get caught cheating, then the win will not count. If you constantly cheat, then you'll be disqualified from the tryhard reward, obviously. More important information, even if you follow the rules, 1v1 games do not count as wins, just because dealing with 1v1 skill-wise could be completely unbalanced. Fighting someone 1v1 is a whole different experience than fighting 1v1v1v1, aka a free-for-all with all 4 players. I also do not want people to take this super competitively. The minigames are supposed to be fun, and this award is supposed to be something that you look at and go like, huh, that's pretty cool and interesting. If people start taking this super seriously and getting legitimately mad if they lose because they just want to win for the award, then I will be removing it. 100% of this world is supposed to be having fun, as long as it's within the rules, not being the best or having the most gear. So if I do need to remove it, the final winner will get their name put up on a wall and no one else will be able to achieve it. So the awards that you will win for all of these awards, so if you get the BFF reward or the social networker, or any of these awards, you will get a choice between an enchanted pickaxe or enchanted boots. The reason why I picked those is because diamond armor really isn't that valuable since it's duplicated and all that stuff, and diamond boots are really useful because they give you a lot of mobility and they can give you feather falling. Honestly, I think boots are the best enchantment that you could do. And pickaxe, just because, you know, if you want to be the type of person to, instead of explore the world, you want to be a builder, then that would be great to get an enchanted pickaxe as well. So those are the two awards. Awards may be added in the future, but right now that is the only two awards existing at this time. So let's say someone decides to go for the tryhard. Actually, no, that's not a very good one. Let's decide someone goes for the BFF one. And let's say this guy gets the BFF for, I don't know, he has it for 3 months. What happens if he breaks his pickaxe, or, you know, every week where these are updated? he's always on the leaderboard. Well, he's not going to get an enchanted pickaxe every week. How it works is, let's say he has the enchanted pickaxe for a month and he's still on the award, then he'll just get another award as well. So he can basically keep on repeating, but it's not going to be constant, hey, you're going to get a new pickaxe every week, because what's going to happen is someone's going to build a whole loot box of 20,000 pickaxes that they're never even going to have the opportunity to touch. So it's just going to kind of stay in place. Let's say you happen to lose your pickaxe right after you got the award. I'm not going to promise that it will be replaced. For example, if you're really careless and you decide to do some parkour in the nether over a lava pit and then you die and it's burned, then you're probably not going to get another pickaxe for a little while, because just because I don't want people thinking, oh, well, it doesn't matter if I'm careful, I'm just going to waste these supplies. Because the thing about enchanted stuff is, even though the diamonds are duplicated, someone still needs to mine those 30 XP levels for the enchanted gear. So that is why I just want to make sure and make it clear that we're not going to replace stuff if you're careless. If you happen to, you know, accidentally fall off a cliff while trying to help the world or something, then I'll probably immediately replace your pickaxe if you lose it. But it really depends on the scenario of whether you'll immediately get one if you lose it or not. And to start off, for the first month, so probably, I'll probably say at the first day of September, let's say, that's going to be the date. The first day of September, the awards will be added, so like the winners. So the winner of the social networker will be up here. And this award, and then this award, and then this award. The reason why I'm giving it a month is if I immediately start the awards, like today, it should probably fluctuate so much because everyone will start at an even level. I kind of want people to get like a head start and, you know, kind of get the things situated, and then it will slowly increase. That's why I predict. If we start it from day one, it's gonna go from like, oh, Gaia Legend to Cadillac to Schlegel My Bagel to Top Shot Nick to Counter-Strike. It's just gonna change so much. If we give it a month, it would transition a lot slower. So I'm gonna wait till September 1st, then the first awards will go out, and then you'll see the winners. And then weekly, on every Sunday, I will make an updated video, if it's necessary, on who the new awards people are. So let's say you have a winner on a Sunday, and then all of a sudden the next day you actually take the lead. You're not going to get the award immediately. You need to hold it until Sunday, and then that's whenever the awards will go out. So that should basically explain all the basics about the awards.